If you just glanced at this new MacBook Pro, you'd swear nothing's changed. It's the same chassis, got the same ports, same beautiful space black finish. What if I told you Apple just dropped one of the biggest upgrades for creators, power users, and even gamers without changing anything on the outside? You see, what's actually changed goes way deeper than just pure specs. Underneath, Apple's made it possible to handle workflows that would have made last year's model sweat, whether you're pushing 8K video, running real-time AI tasks, or finally taking gaming seriously on a Mac. Let's talk about what's changed, starting with the star of the show, the M5 chip. The biggest difference in this MacBook Pro is the new M5. Apple's using their latest 3-nanometer process here, which gives you better performance and efficiency. But the real story is how they've boosted every part of the chip that matters for getting work done. The CPU gets a solid bump in both single and multi-core tasks, which is noticeable if you're doing things like compiling code or rendering or working with huge files. But it's the GPU that stands out this time. Every GPU core now has its own neural accelerator, which is a first for Apple. This makes anything involving AI, like on-device language models or local image generation, run much faster, and it means heavy creative apps just feel more responsive. Memory bandwidth is up too, now at 153 gigabytes per second. If you're juggling huge projects or running multiple demanding apps, you'll actually notice less waiting around for things to load, render, or process. It's not a radical overhaul, but it is the most capable 14-inch base model MacBook Pro yet, if you care about performance, especially for demanding modern workflow. Now, here are a couple of real world examples to show what I mean. I love Craft Docs and I use it on all my Apple devices. They have these built-in LLMs to allow you to interact with the app and your documents and notes and anything that you basically put in there. And you do it by chatting with its AI. The new MacBook Pro was built with these on-device local models in mind, keeping your data secure. And as you can see, I can quickly chat back and forth. Again, none of this is going to the internet. None of this is going to the cloud. This is all local on my device. Another popular AI use case is image generation, which most people do in the cloud and don't even realize you can do locally on your machine using an app like Draw Things, which is free, by the way. This app has come a long way in the past couple of years, and with the M5's GPU power, iteration speeds up and image diffusion models just run a lot faster. Again, I can make images right here locally on my MacBook Pro. One more example, video upscaling in Topaz Video sees a dramatic jump, almost twice as fast as last year's M4 and almost 8 times faster than the M1 for AI enhanced upscaling, allowing me to take old standard definition clips of video and make them look presentable here in the modern age. We're talking about typical normal laptop times for tasks that used to be something that you would queue up and walk away and come back to later. Now, of course, it's not just the M5 chip. Storage also got a nice upgrade as well. First, the SSD is faster. It's something you notice when you're copying huge project files or scrubbing through massive video timelines. Files are going to open quicker, exports are going to move along with less waiting, and the whole machine just feels snappier under load. Also, for the first time on the entry-level 14-inch MacBook Pro, you can go all the way up to 4 terabytes of storage. That's double the 2 terabyte limit that we had previously on the base model. I just so happen to be testing the 4 terabyte model here, and the extra space is just nice to have. Nothing wrong with a little extra breathing room. Of course, that's a pretty expensive upgrade though, and you can always just take advantage of fast external storage using the Thunderbolt ports. That's actually my preferred method of video editing, by the way. I keep everything on an external Thunderbolt drive, allowing me to easily move my projects between different Macs just by plugging it in. All right, let's talk gaming and graphics. Let's be real. A lot of people still don't see the Mac as a place to game, but Apple's been chipping away at that belief over the past few years with Apple Silicon. The M5's GPU builds on what started with the M3. Hardware accelerated ray tracing continues to get faster, as do frame rates. Apple says you'll see up to 60% higher frame rates over last generation's M4, which is a huge single year increase. With Metal Effects upscaling, you can finally hit smooth 1080p 60 in titles like Cyberpunk 2077 and Resident Evil on the base MacBook Pro. Apple's laptops legitimately have the power and ability at this point to play AAA games, and it's more of a wait for developers to invest in bringing their games to the Mac at a faster pace. Now, another first as it pertains to the base 14-inch MacBook Pro is that you can get it with the optional nano-texture glass. If you've ever tried editing in a room with harsh overheads or a sun-blasted window, you know the struggle. Nano-texture is like an invisibility cloak for reflections, but without killing the XDR display's punch. I really like it, and if you can relate, you should go with this option as well. Now, I'm not the biggest fan of it on larger displays like the iMac or the Studio Display or the Pro Display XDR, but on the iPad and MacBook Pros, I think it is actually really nice. All the other essentials are still on deck. Thunderbolt 4 ports for heavy duty accessories, full-size HDMI for your monitor, MagSafe for worry-free charging, SD card slot for fast media offloads, and yes, even the headphone jack is still here. Apple's XDR display is still incredible for HDR grading, supporting up to 1600 nits, and ProMotion 120 Hz keeps every scroll feeling smooth. And if you're upgrading from an Intel or the M1 MacBook Pro, the speakers, microphones, and keyboard are going to just feel like you skipped a whole decade. So who is this actually for? If you're on an Intel or M1, this is a no-brainer of an upgrade. For M2 or M3 owners, it may only be worth the leap if you're pushing local AI or have massive project sizes or you're doing heavy video or next-gen games. That said, I would suspect if that's you, you're probably on one of the Pro or Max chips anyway, and then this would end up being a downgrade. If you're considering moving from a MacBook Air over to the base Pro, you're getting a much nicer display, much nicer speakers, faster storage, way better battery life, and options for up to 4 terabyte storage and nano texture. The new 14-inch MacBook Pro with M5 isn't focused on headline grabbing design changes. Instead, it's making pro level speed and modern workflows feel a lot more effortless, even in the entry level model. Local AI, 4 terabytes of storage, real gaming potential, a nano texture screen option, and speed increases across the board are the upgrades that matter here. This year, it's what's on the inside that counts. And if you want something radically new on the outside, you'll likely be waiting another year. Thanks for watching as always, guys. I appreciate your support. I'm Andrew Edwards, and I will catch you in the next video.